Hello, ladies, gents, and mewing giga-chats. We return to the most obscure, challenging, yet pointless side quest that Spelunky 2 features. It is absolutely 100% not worth it. I thought that I would just be doing a one-episode throwaway kind of experience. Oh, man. I'm already going to have to coach this into... I'm going to be even worse than usual because I have a slice right through the finger that I used to press down the right arrow. I put my hand right into a freaking blender, you would say. You could say. Got my finger all sliced up. Really stupid. This quest line is so dumb and worthless. There was a comment saying, I have no idea what the hell Derek was thinking about this one with this one. It's like, you do all this extra busy work. All this silly side... Oh, wait, we have to steal this crap. Ah, shit. You son of a bitch. He's gonna shoot me in the back. I completely forgot. Oh, but now this is kind of like not in the way, right? So maybe we can... You know... Get into the corner. If you use the camera, do you still get labeled as a vandal? If I whip this... Do something like this. Okay, we're gonna put it there. Put it right there. I'm gonna grab that, put it there, whip it. Okay, that's good, that's great. Don't shoot my back. You know what? I'm gonna put a rope right there. Don't shoot me in the back, you maniac. You did good. Every time, man. I don't know why I even try. It's like, once you screw up the beginning of it, just give up, restart, or maybe find yourself another shop, because you already screwed up the position, and he has plenty of opportunity to just obliterate your anus. What I should have done, actually, was grab it while I was facing the other way. Everything's under the control, don't worry about it. All right, that somehow managed to be... To be 100% kosher. It was great. Anyway, I was taking out the trash, right? I was taking out the trash. I reached into the next item to toss into the dumpster. Turned out to be an extremely sharp-edged freaking hanger sliced straight into my finger. And now, like, it was bleeding profusely. I had no tissues, anything. I was in the damn dumpster surrounded by detritus. You know, the transfer site you may know about. See, this one did not get shot. I didn't get me shot in the head, in the back. Could you stay up there, buddy? We're going to steal all your junk, rob you blind, get the hell out of there. I had no tissues in the car, I had absolutely nothing. Had to use my shirt to staunch the flow of blood. It was very traumatic. Why am I doing things like this when I can just whip him in the butt? The speakers are a little too loud. I mean, turn them down a little bit. There you go. Don't want any kind of echoes to interfere with the recording. Hopefully the fans are not interfering with the recording. It is the freaking summer. I think I have established pretty clearly that summer's in Alaska. You might be surprised, they're actually extremely hot and dry. So, you know, you have to turn on all the fans. Eventually, I'll give up and I will use the AC. We shouldn't have done that. We want more flesh. What the hell kind of nonsense was this? There's no way this fella is going to make it all the way to the... I'll tell you, it's just gonna die a terrible death. All right, we need, I think, one more point. So anyway, lots of blood got all over my shirt, you know, on purpose, because that was the only option that I had. Get back into the car, you know, get done, get rid of all the damn trash. I'm bleeding. And something you may or may not know about me, I have a thing. I do have a thing. It's not about blood. It is about slicing your flesh open. If there is a cut the slices. Oh, this is not gonna make it to the damn altar. What am I doing? Let me just maybe put a bomb there. Grab myself the key. Now I have no access back to the altar. I do have climbing gloves, so we can do something like this. We'll have created a nice shortcut. Apparently the shopkeeper has been thoroughly murdered. Okay, hopefully we got enough time to get this to the altar. Start feeling lightheaded. Anything that slices, that hurt. Pressing down the arrow, that hurt. I thought I had enough, but I guess not. We do have a shopkeeper at the bottom. Maybe we can still make it happen. I discovered it way, way back when I was a teenager. My mother cut herself real bad fixing up dinner. I wanted to go help her, stand next to her in the sink. I caught sight of that sliced finger. Oh, man, it gives me the heebie-jeebies just thinking about it. It's not actually the heebie-jeebies. I literally start feeling a little flustered, a little lightheaded. The cold sweat starts. It's like a real thing. It is very infuriating, right? Because psychologically, rationally, I have no problem with it. There's something in the wiring of my brain that just makes me vulnerable to it. And I don't think exposure could possibly fix it. It's just, you know, a weakness of mine that I just have to deal with. It is very crippling if I am ever in a situation where I need to help somebody that has a gushing wound. It sucks. You know, it's just the way that my brain got put together. I feel like I lucked out pretty good where my brain is concerned. I am not complaining. If this is the debuff that I have to deal with in exchange of having the brain that I ended up with, you know what? I'll take it. But that being said, I am curious to see maybe exposure will change it. But, you know, even videos. I have seen videos on YouTube of like operations and stuff like that. It just destroys me. It makes me lightheaded. I need to go lay down with literal flusters and cold sweats. I hate it, but it's just the way that my brain works. Let me grab a shotgun and we're going to go through the jungle. No, wait. We want Volcana because we want the guaranteed key. By the way, I haven't even established. I know that I am mid-anecdote. I have been stretching this anecdote, being sidetracked 20 several times. Let's begin. Let's establish the way or what you need to do for this silly Sparrow questline. Because it truly is stupid. You need to first steal an item. That one's very easy to get across, right? You just go and steal an item. And then you find Sparrow in 2-1. That is the number one thing that you have to do. That is the thing that everybody's aware of. Then you go and steal the ivory idol. What am I doing? Go and steal the ivory idol from Madame Tusk without her dying. She can catch you. She just cannot die. All right? Then I am a little fuzzy on this particular detail. I think that the next part, you need to find Sparrow in Neo Babylon. Man, this is a nightmare. I hate it. Wow. You need to find Sparrow in Neo Babylon. And she will like, oh, hell yeah, let's do the heist together. Stick it up to Madame Tusk. So then you have the means to rob Madame Tusk together, and then you get to, ooh, what a privilege, share the booty with her at the end of the quest line. Instead of getting the whole stash, you get half of it. Aren't you lucky? Damn! so generous. So you do all this extra work in exchange for one rope pile and the opportunity to give up half your money. How very generous. You know what? It's time for this to go away. This piece of trash needs to be let go. There you go. Boom! I want all that lava gone. And by gone, I mean running rampant through the dire level. Apparently. I hate this. I hate this. Boy, do I hate it. Get me out of here. So that's what we're trying to do. And I was only aware of the half where you get Madame Tusk's idol, and that's it. Because otherwise, if you don't do all that busy work... Holy crap, that was extremely upsetting. Alright, alright. A little bit closer to the end here. I think the lava is done coming down. That's the exit. Let's get rid of you. There you go. So anyway, here I am driving back home. It's only a 5-minute drive, but the transfer site is very close. Driving back home, and I despite my best efforts, I cannot stop thinking about the way that that sharp edge went into my finger. And it made it bleed so profusely. It is just all that occupies my mind. I start singing. I start putting my brain wherever it will go except there. But it's an obsession. It's a fixation. It cannot be distracted from being fully occupied by the experience of getting my flesh cut open. No amount of Joan Manuel Serrat singing will stop it. Tu nombre me sabe a hierba. No, none of that. I was trying so hard to be Kabuba. To be distracted. But no, it will not do it. So I feel myself getting dizzier and dizzier as I am driving home. I am behind the wheel. I have to put on the hazard lights. Kinda go over to the side of the road and slow down. Just in case I just lose consciousness, because you see, it has happened before. I wish it weren't so. I keep saying, I wish I weren't, I didn't have this freaking superhero weakness. Oh, yeah, give me all this blood, baby. Well, you're supposed to be hurting the vampire. You're not supposed to be hurting the grunks. Now the grunks are dead. Hey, oh well, he's dead. But we got plenty of health, so it's all good. All right. Let's not forget the key. We gotta go back for the key. I think it's at the very entrance, so it's not a big deal. It's not a freaking silly. It's not a silly hunt. Just a retrieval. There it is. It has happened before. And it happens when it is in conjunction with me seeing the flesh cut open and I am hungry. Happened before my... And, you know, this is even further shameful because he was just getting a diabetic test. My father had just acquired his diabetes. And he was testing himself and he was like, let's test you. And I was fasting, you know, from not having eaten anything in the morning. And boy, getting myself poked while having an extremely empty stomach, being hypoglycemic, it just did me in. I literally passed out, freaked out my parents so hard. And it established me as a pathetic little wimp that cannot withstand even a pathetic little poke in the finger. So anyway, you know, due to this experience, why am I carrying this? Why am I carrying this piece of garbage when I have a key to babysit? from this experience, I was like, I am in real danger of passing out behind the wheel. This is something that I cannot abide. Unfortunately, I was not fast enough. And while I was driving, I was like gone. Lost consciousness while the car was still moving. Woke up like, I don't know, a minute later, 5 minutes later, there was a smear of blood on the side of the road. And there was a woman just screaming murder. I look on the side of the road. I had run over her pet monkey. I quickly screeched out of there, running over the woman as I did so, because obviously you don't want to leave any witnesses. And I haven't heard from it yet. I came back here and started recording. Hopefully the police, they don't look at people's online presence, right? Should be perfectly safe. It should be. Oh, we have freaking climbing gloves. This should be pretty good. Should be pretty good. All right, that was a bit. That is the end of the bit. I will tell you, I got home safely, and then I quickly enlisted my wife to provide me with nutrition, because I was like, oh, I'm getting the dizzy spell. I'm getting the hypoglycemic thing. Please bring me a glass of juice or some of that chocolate milk that we got in there. You know, whatever. She brought it to me. You drink it, it's weird. It's like, you can literally feel that glucose filling up your veins and taking away all your maladies. Feels like it's a freaking drug addiction. It's a condition, really. Not something that I worry about often, but you know, with the entire thing, the bleeding, it really exacerbated it. I used to get it quite often, being hypoglycemic. Haven't gotten that a dizzy spell in quite a while. I was even fasting for quite a long time, never eating breakfast, just drinking lots of water in the morning, and I never really had the problem. But that entire ordeal with getting the terrible cut brought it back. Come on. There you are. Why am I doing Olmec anyway? I can simply skip him, right? But, you know, it's an extra life. Quite clearly, I need every bit of help that I can get. So we're going to get that Unk at the top of this tower. Thinking I should probably have established the entire quest line before even starting, instead of doing an episode 4 of something that I thought would be a one and done. Do I want a slave? Sure, why not? It's been quite the dearth of slaves. I used them as flesh bags earlier. Now I have to train a brand new one. It's just always such an inconvenience. Such an inconvenience. Anyway, while I was recovering my sweet, sweet spouse, cleaned up the wound and bandaged it up. It's good. She was like, what the hell? This is so deep. What the hell? What were you doing? I gave me a chance to blame her, because it was her hanger that she threw away. So I had an opportunity to put all the blame on her shoulders, make her feel bad, and by extension, make me feel better in comparison. Because marriage is like 50% of it. It's just a game of one-upmanship. Here's a key. We're going to use it to steal. Like, if you go through a day without putting your spouse down in order to make yourself feel better, what are you even doing? What the hell did you sign that marriage certificate for? How foolish. Let's get Trepanator right through the exit. Okay, so I want to do it so they don't see me, but it is pretty hard to do. Something you can do, though, is you can gamble before and then do it. Let's do it. I hate this. And I hate you, Madam Tusk, for corrupting the youth. Driving all of those Spelunky fans to watch Twitch gambling streams. throw their money away to a fool's errand. Absolutely ridiculous. Disgusting and deplorable. This scheme that you have going on here. We got plenty of time still. I am now all done. Fine, we're gonna go in there. I think they only get mad if you come out with it, right? Hey, hey, I opened it. Yeah, yeah, he has no trouble. Maybe we can actually, preemptively, we can do something like this. Ooh, he won't get mad if I bomb that, right? Do something like that, and then eventually he will go down there, get himself impaled. Thing is, oh, that was actually a mistake, because she needs to survive. He won't see me. He won't see me. Oh, baby, stealth. Absolute ninja. Eat my ass, Madam Tusk. Right under your nose. You filthy, disgusting fatso. All right, all done. Let me continue training this slave into being an obedient member of this team. We do have the opportunity. We do have the opportunity to get ourselves a sword. Let's open this up and carry on with my life. Ah, been working, I want to say non-stop, but that's a lie. I've been so lazy lately, just barely getting around to all my long-term projects. But I have been working off and on, releasing my next novel. You may remember way, way, way back, I said, you know, one day, or rather, it has been an ongoing thing. I will look over the shoulder, my wife's shoulder, and take a glimpse at the absolute garbage that she's reading. She does read. This is just between you and me. I am revealing a bad habit of hers, but it's shared among many, many women out there. She does enjoy her smutty novels now and then. It's not like all she reads, but, you know, she will indulge herself in such things now and then, and by her own admission, is not something that came out of me to begin with. By her own admission, is like, the writing on this is just so bad. It's like absolutely trash. But you know, this mutt is this mutt. She's going to consume it. So, so she tells me this writing on this is so bad, and I have read something over her shoulder, and I was like, holy crap, man, this is just like third grade level writing. What is this nonsense? Like, obviously not all, right? Not all, but the standard of prose, let's just say, it is not the absolute highest. The them authors out there, and I have gone at length about this before, how I'm not even mad, because they will pump out books like every, there's some that will do it one a month. It's like, just typing that out, you have my utmost respect, because even if I turn off my brain, I would not be able to do that. I am incapable of writing out a coherent story, a somewhat coherent story, in the span of 1 month. Absolutely not. That ain't gonna happen. So I do have a level of respect for the people, mostly women, that are capable of, you know, churning out such a lengthy amount of text in such a short amount of time. We don't need to go to the entire thing. We don't really care. We're just going to keep on going. We are keeping the clone gun and the... Oh, wait, we do want the quest line, don't we? I mean, it's not necessary, but it would be nice. Holy crap, Gronk, you're making me so freaking upset. Just looking at you. Stop it! Absolute buffoon. Okay, let me just toss you. I want you to... Stop! Stop. Alright. Grab the... I'm trying to grab him. There! Blood pressure has been increasing steadily. What are you doing? Grab the clone gun. He's too dumb. He's too stupid. Too stupid to live. Literally too stupid to live. Oh, I am too stupid to avoid this guy. Thank goodness it dropped me down here. That's what I was aiming for. So, you know, not the greatest material, right? So I was like, you know what? I'm going to write you one. I'm going to... And this is something that I really appreciated because it really put me out of my comfort zone. I am not this muddy kind of guy. I will not... Like, in my usual narratives, my books that you may have, may or may not have read, the most you get is a fade to black. There's some suggestive themes, and then it's a fade to black. You know, and that's the way I like it in the novels that I read as well. It's like, give me some, you know, titillation, some nice lead up to things, and then fade to black when the actual deed is done. Don't actually describe every thrust. That's, you know, it goes beyond what I really enjoy. So I was like, so I'm going to do it. I'm going to write her a smut novel. I'm going to turn off my brain and I'm going to write a smut novel. Well, okay. Smut novel for her. I'm going to churn it out like they do, but you know, with a little bit more love and care. I can do better fast. Fast forward a year and a half later. More or less. And I have finished that novel. And believe me, there is explicit sexual content in this novel. I am framing it like... I'm telling you guys because you guys are, you know, my loyal, wonderful fan base. So I can tell you the secrets, the sausage, how the sausage was made. But I am marketing it as... I received this manuscript one day in my P.O. box, and I read through it, and it's this really funky memoir about this sexually liberated woman. There is, of course, because it's me and I cannot help myself, in every one of my narratives, there has to be an element of fantasy. I just really love fantasy. It is just my favorite genre. And so it's what do they call it? There's an actual name for it. Romantic fantasy. That being said, because I am not a consumer of the genre, I am not 100% about all the conventions and all the things, and I feel like that is actually a positive. I'm not 100% on all the conventions and all the way of doing things in romantic fantasy. So you're going to get something that is actually quite a bit different than your typical romantic fantasy smut. That being said, it is for adults only. I often market the stories Eternal and The Last of the Wicked. Both of them, I would say, you know, very teenager friendly. There's some serious themes in there, but I would be 100% comfortable with like 13 and up kids reading it. And, you know, I wouldn't bat an eyelash. Holy crap! Anyway, we need to find Sparrow here. That is the next step in our chain of events. I wouldn't bite an eyelash if you told me, oh, my 13-year-old kid read The Last of the Wicked and absolutely loved it. It's like, yeah, that is correct. I enjoy that, to learn this. Please, you know, if you have children and you happen to buy this next novel from me, please do not give it to your children. I will feel very, very bad. And you would probably count as a pretty bad parent if you allow that to happen. That being said, it's nothing like perverted. It's nothing awful. But definitely adult content that I would not want anybody under 18. I mean, obviously, you know, a 16-year-old, a 17-year-old, they can consume that. And they have seen way worse on the internet. I am stuck in this horrible place, by the way. I want to find myself a path to freedom here. We also need to find Sparrow. We cannot leave without finding her. Whoa. I think she spawns under a mushroom. You know, one of these mushroom areas. Well, there goes my sword. So let me not leave. Let's just set aside all this silly storytelling narrative thing that I have going for you. Until we find Sparrow. Please, this is such a danger zone. It is just awful. Archer will be proud. Absolutely atrocious. We do need to stick around a little. to find what I'm looking for. Not here. At least we do have... We do have a lot of health cushion even after taking an explosion to the head. She's not here. Where is she? She's supposed to be... Did I miss something? I took the idol out. I'm quite certain it's 6-1. Ow. I have read it on the internet, maybe behind the idol. It's alright. Everything's fine. Can get through this, no problem. There she is! Man, that was... I'm so glad that I went out of my way to make sure that I found her. I'm impressed! Meet me at the Palace of Pleasure if you really want to get rich. You don't even have another rope pile for me, huh? You stingy piece of garbage. You're one hell of a terrible partner in crime. Alright, now we kinda have to make it to the exit quickly. Please do not crush me. The ghost is around the corner. Alright, made it, baby! Beautiful. Okay, now let's go find Madame Tusk. Should be 6-3. Whoopla! Woohoo! Just slowly concentrating on all this thing. Anyway, I started that novel that I am going to release very, very soon. It started as a brainless endeavor trying to churn out a story. You know, still putting thought into it, but basically, my number one directive was, is this fun? If the answer is yes, it belongs. If the answer is no, this is not what you want to write. All right? That was my main directive. Towards the end, I was like, you know what? I am really into this story. This is a very good story. I have like 3 sex scenes down by now. But if you just look at the narrative, it's actually a super fun novel to read. So, you know, I made sure that everything made sense. I made a lot of alterations, so everything was very lore-friendly. There is... Once again, I may have gone a little overboard with world-building. Okay, Sparrow is not here. Oh, it's you. Please enjoy my food. I'm going to rob all your food. I'm going to rob you so hard. She's also not down here. She just... she is next to the bottom entrance. And the door should be open for us to steal everything. Open that up. So we gotta make it to the bottom here. Quite the nightmare. Hopefully this elevator ride will not be rife with terrible traps. So good, baby. Ow! Really could use some extra bombs. Okay, I think I have chosen the entirely wrong path. There's no exit out of here. So let me just get back up. Take a laser to the butthole. Careful, careful. Oh, I almost panicked right into being crushed. And the game itself prevented that from happening. Yes, yeah, she knocked out the bodyguard. She's not a murderer, she's a thief. If you get past the lasers, I'll split the treasure with you. How generous! You did all that work of opening one door. You know what? I'm actually not able to get past the lasers because I have no bombs. Well, well, well. I mean, this counts. This totally counts. Bruh. I don't have the bombs to get in there. Ba-boom. They're so mad now. They're so freaking mad. This totally counts. I am not redoing this whole thing. I am not. I refuse. Get crushed, bitch. Get me out of here. Oh, hello. Oh, I can't get you through. I was like, here's my answer. But no. Well, I almost got myself lavaed to oblivion. Yeah, I am completely unable to finish this stupid-ass quest. Because I did not realize I needed to get past the lasers. Needed 3 bombs for that. Needed to save at least one more. That could have easily have been reflected at me. And this run has been complete trash ass garbage where bombs are concerned. I'm trying to maybe find... maybe find a source of explosives. Callie will not give them to me. Whew. Shotgun will not do it. I think we're SOL. There is just no way to make this will happen. No way to make this work. I tried so hard. We got so far. In the end, it didn't even matter. I guess we'll... Yo! Is that a crush or does it just put you under the mushroom? I've actually never tested that. For science! Alright, good. I'm pretty sure it has happened before, but never on purpose. Well, that's a tragedy. Get this cat through. At the very least, we can just have a revenge on this crazy bitch. She should drop a freaking bomb when I... Whoa! She just drop a bomb when I rope her. But no such thing. Now she's just going to make mincemeat out of my butthole. She's going to visit nothing but pain upon my person. Here she is, just giving me the beating of her life. She doesn't care that I am her brother. She does not give a crap about familial ties. She's all about that bag, and she's going to just violently demonstrate her complete lack of regard for my person. It doesn't matter that I may have accidentally... Wow. Ow! I may have accidentally roped her. Completely unwillingly. No, she is completely devoid of remorse, regard for my safety, or care about my person. Oh well, what you want to do about it? What you want to do about it? This counts, and that's it. That's all I got for you. I am done with this silly quest line. I can now go back to Greeny Porcini and go into the mod. Let's just leave her alone, okay? Give me bubbles. We're going to go all the way to the top and we're going to one shot this skip. Don't even worry about it. I know that you guys have no faith in me because you're heathens. Ow, my finger hurt. I burnt it. You son of a bitch. I have lots of ropes, so I don't really mind throwing away a few. How do I want to do it? I think I will do it from the top. There is the alternative of just going through the bottom and jumping the laser a few times and then starting at the bottom. But I like doing it like this better. Alrighty. You son of a bitch. That alone makes me extremely nervous about my ability to pull this off. I would like to preface this with, I haven't done this in probably like a year. So this is gonna be bad. I forgot to throw another rope up. That would have been pretty good. Or rather, if I had simply hang on to the ledge, right? But did not have the presence of mind to avoid the laser. Oh well, at least I actually pulled off the hard part and then botched the easy part. Very shameful, very pathetic. I hate everything. Let's go back into the mod and we're going to try to do the same steps and see if there's anything different going on there.